Mobile computing is great, but one of the challenges with mobile computing is that laptops can be lost and stolen. It's truly amazing that 2 million laptops a year are reported stolen, and 97% of those are never found. What's most important in these cases is the data that's on the laptop. It's reported, according to industry reports, that the cost associated with a lost laptop approaches $50,000. Intel has made it a goal to help mitigate some of these risks. In conjunction with our partners, we have created hardware technology that can lower the impact of a lost or stolen laptop. With Intel anti-theft technology, it becomes possible to send a poison pill to the laptop, so that laptop essentially becomes inoperable and can't be used by the bad guy, the guy that actually stole it. We've also taken into account with this technology the ability to add policy that doesn't have reliance on the network delivering that poison pill to the laptop, because it might never end up back on the network. So for example, it's possible to set up a policy that if the laptop doesn't check back in such a frequency that it can become disabled, or if a number of failed login attempts are breached, that it also can't be logged into and the platform itself becomes disabled. We've also added additional things besides just the platform itself becoming disabled that can be an action in the case of one of these theft scenarios. For example, we can work with encryption vendors to make it such that it's more difficult to get access to encrypted data on the platform when one of these events occur that signify that the laptop has been stolen. And finally, when the laptop is recovered, or if it was lost and then found, we have technology as part of the anti-theft solution that enables rapid recovery and enablement of the platform back to an operational state when it's in the hands of the rightful owner. This provides a comprehensive set of technologies that really helps provide serious mitigation for these theft and loss scenarios. But let's go ahead and look at this in action. Josh is going to show us how Intel anti-theft technology really works. Josh?
Thanks, Steve. In this demonstration, I'm going to show you a little bit about Intel anti-theft technology. And the specific model I'm looking at here is the Intel Core i5 vPro processor with Intel anti-theft technology. Now, let's say, for example, this laptop is stolen, and it's anywhere in the world. Doesn't matter. It's not here, and it's not with the end user that is supposed to have it. This end user, when he calls in and says, hey, my laptop's stolen, what do I do? What happens is the IT administrator, through some quick verification, is able to send down a kill pill. What's new about the kill pill is that it doesn't just do a hardware disable, it actually does a data disable. And by doing so, it deletes the encryption components that are stored in the chipset. So now this machine is remedied useless and a brick. Now for the common thief, they're gonna boot it up, they're gonna get to a specific screen and really not know what to do. Now if this machine is recovered by the end user, they're able to call back into the help desk. And what that help desk is able to do is walk them through the critical steps needed to bring this machine back online. In prior technology, software-based solutions, once the software enacted the kill pill, you couldn't get back into the data. With a hardware-based solution, you are today. Now, let me go ahead and swing this around, and I'm gonna put in a challenge response, and you'll see this over here on the console, where I'm able to take a challenge from the end user after verification, the information, and let's do that now. Now, at this point, I'm going to say that, hey, the machine is not stolen. Let's recover it. I'm able to get a response back, and I'm able to tell that response to the end user over the phone so they can get back to being productive. And what they're left with is a screen that looks like this. Once the challenge is there, they're typing in the response, and they're able to hit OK. The machine comes back and says yes. Assets not stolen. It's going to reboot this machine up to a productive state back into the operating system for the end user. What's important for a corporation is the protection of the data, the PC, and getting this to either be back in the hands of the end user or to make this a brick, both data and the PC. So for the corporation, this is a great thing to protect their assets. Now, for a common thief, what's the value of stealing this laptop if I can't get to the data or I can't get to the hardware? We think that's going to deter them from taking the laptop. And this is why this is smart security.
One of the most valuable assets that an enterprise has is its data and intellectual property. It is critical to protect this data and intellectual property by encrypting it, especially when it's on mobile platforms. One of the challenges, though, is when you encrypt a platform, it becomes a little bit more challenging to manage it because the operating system and all of the data and applications are encrypted. So if you wanted to do something like wake the machine up and patch it, that operation would be a bit more difficult because when the platform boots, it would actually boot and wait for credentials to be entered. By utilizing a new capability that Intel's introducing in 2010, we're able to help resolve this issue by making it such that you can now remotely boot a platform, provide appropriate credentials, have the platform become unlocked, and then perform any management operation. This essentially makes it such that the IT enterprise no longer needs to choose between, do I want to protect my data or do I want to have a manageable platform? The enterprise can now have both. Let's hear from Steven Sprague, CEO of Wave Systems, on how this works in the real world.
Hello, my name is Steven Sprague, and I'm CEO of Wave Systems. And we're here to show how vPro technology from Intel can provide better manageability of encrypted hard drives. So we've brought with us today two Dell Latitude laptops. Each of these has an encrypted hard drive in the machine. And the purpose of an encrypted hard drive is in the case that you lose your laptop or lose control of your laptop, that the data is safe. Now this is accomplished by providing a password to unlock the hard drive. The problem with that is that that password has basically really stopped the manageability of these machines, because I have to have a user interaction with the client machine to accomplish that. So we're here to show how vPro technology can provide an out-of-band management of the credential for the encrypted drive and unlock the machine. So first we'll start by just powering on the computer, and we can do this with vPro technology across the network, and we wake up the computer. Once the machine wakes up, you stop at this screen where I have to enter a password. And this is typically where manageability has been a real problem, because I can't unlock this without somebody physically present at the computer. So now we're able to perform an over-the-network unlock of the computer. And so he'll perform an unlock, and we'll watch that the machine actually will now boot to Windows without us entering any password into the computer. And so it's fairly quick, and it provides now a machine that's open and available for manageability. You could re-image this computer, you could modify different configurations or settings, deploy new applications, whatever's necessary over the network, and then power it off. This solution provides a great answer to the problem of the trade-off between security and manageability. By combining the Wave Systems Enterprise Server and Intel vPro technology, it's now possible for the corporation to be able to have full control of their encrypted solutions in the marketplace and to provide an easy-to-use and easy-to-manage solution.